There are many ways that you can pick a random winner using Excel. Let's look at three of them. So in this first example, we're going to use the RAND function. So here I have a list of my contestants' usernames. So next to the first one, I'll type equals RAND, short for random, and open and close parentheses. And with this first value generated, I'm going to double click on this bottom right corner so I can autofill it so that each contestant's name now has a random value next to it. Now, it's important to note that the RAND function is a volatile function. And this means that whenever you make any change in your sheet, the values are going to change. So let's say I want to change contestant names to entries, all my values change. If I press Ctrl Z on my keyboard to undo it, all my values change again. To preserve the integrity of this drawing, I don't want my values to keep changing. So I'm going to select all of the RAND values, copy them, and then right click. And in the paste options, I'm going to select the option with the 1, 2, 3. That's the paste as values option. And this is going to just keep the values of the formula and get rid of the actual live formula in that cell. Now that the numbers are no longer changing, I can go into the data tab in the sort and filter section and click to sort. Now, it doesn't matter if you sort from smallest to largest or largest to smallest. The important thing is that you've used random values to sort your list, and then you can simply select the name at the top as your winner. Sidebar, you may want to consider doing a screen recording of you going through the process of selecting the winner. This way you'll have documentation of the process that you used and which winner was selected. And there are tons of different tools that you can use for this. And we're talking roughly a 30-second video, so you don't necessarily need any fancy video editing software. Personally, I like TechSmith's Snagit tool. It's affordable and I find it easy to use. For clarity, TechSmith is not sponsoring this video. I just really like them. But I do have an affiliate link that you can use to purchase their software that way while supporting this channel. So if you are interested, you'll find that link in the description for this video. But just something to consider as you go through this process of selecting winners. So for the second example, we'll look at choosing a random winner by using Excel formulas. And there are several ways that you can nest different functions together to do this. They all have the same result of picking one out of a list. For this particular example, we're going to use the index function. So we'll type equals index, open parentheses, and for the array, we'll select all of the names on the list, because this is where we want our result to come from, comma. So next, we need to know which row the winner will be selected from, but we need for this to be random. So to accomplish this, we're going to nest the RANDBETWEEN function here. So we'll type RANDBETWEEN, open parentheses, and RANDBETWEEN works by selecting a random value between a range of numbers that you specify, like between 1 and 10, for example. So we need to set a bottom and top number, with the top number equaling the number of entries to select from. So the minimum value that we want to use for this example is going to be 1, comma, and then the top value, or max value, will need to be the number of entries. So for this field, we're going to nest the COUNTA function, which counts the number of cells in your selection that are not blank. In other words, the maximum number will be the number of contestants. So we'll open parentheses and we'll select all of the contestants again. Then close parentheses again, and finish our formula. And now we have a winner. So like before, keep in mind that RANDBETWEEN is also a volatile function. So you'll need either a video that you stop at this point once you have your winner selected, or you can use the copy paste as values feature to erase the formula and keep only the result. Just know that when you do this, your winner is going to change again. In this third example, we're going to use a formula to randomly choose multiple winners at the same time. So let's say you plan to have three winners for your contest or your giveaway. This is something that you could use for this. So we'll again use the index function. So type index, open parentheses, and we'll again select the contestant usernames for our array because that's where we want the result to come from, comma, and here we're going to nest the RANDARRAY function. And RANDARRAY returns a set of random values, but you get to decide how big or small your set will be. And that makes this perfect for what we're trying to do. So the first field is the number of rows, and we're going to type 3 because we want 3 winners returned, and I want them listed in a row. So comma, for columns, I'm going to type 1 because I only need one column, and then type comma. And now we need to set the minimum and maximum values, kind of like we did with the RANDBETWEEN function. So like before, the minimum value will be 1, but the maximum value again needs to match the number of entries in our contest. So we're going to again nest the COUNTA function, so that the number of cells containing entries or usernames will equal the maximum value that a random number can be. So we'll select the usernames again, close parentheses again, one more time, and press enter. Now we have our 3 winners. So again, if you are capturing this on video or a screen grab, you can maybe finish here, but because this is still a volatile function, I'm going to again copy these, paste them as values, and those are my winners. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.